Over the 18 years, 18 seasons, or something like that.
The original's the best.
Ah, thank you very much. That's my personal opinion. So let me introduce myself. My name is Walter Jones. I am Zach, the original Black Ranger. What's up?
Hi, I'm Catherine Sutherland. I was Cat in the second Pink Ranger.
Hi, everyone. I'm Karen Ashley. I'm Aisha, the Yellow Ranger. Yeah. Woo!
Hi, my name is Rocky DeSantos, the Red Ranger, and I also play Steve Cardenas when I'm not on TV. Yeah.
Very good action.
So we understand you guys might have a few questions for us. Well, what's up with that? Yes, hi Chris.
Can you and Johnny, like, just play something or whatever?
Have a dance-off.
I'm gonna win the dance-off, I'll tell you that much.
Who's the better Black Ranger
between Johnny and myself? Well, I would have to say that we were very different.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I had my own form of martial arts, which was hip-hop keto, right?
Yeah.
Johnny did his thing, you know. So I think we're both, we both gained a lot of fans in our own individual way. But I was the best at what I did. If you, would you stand up when you ask a question so we can hear you?
My question is for Steve. Out of the two Rangers you were, which did you prefer more, red or blue?
Well, that's a good question. I like the red one. I mean, like, I like that costume because that you know, the stigma of being the Red Ranger is like really cool. But I liked Zio too because and when I first started, I was like really nervous and I didn't really have a lot of experience. So I don't think that I really had developed my character. So, and Zio, I liked my character and the direction that he went better, but I liked the red costume better, so. Yeah.
Very cool.
Well, hold on, we have to come back over here, yeah.
When you guys first started off, like in this show, did you have any apprehensions? Like, did you wonder, you know, like, what are we getting ourselves into?
Well, I was in the show at the very beginning, and so, yeah, there was definitely apprehensions. It was like, the audition process was pretty big. I mean, we auditioned for a number of days, and they saw a lot of different people, and after we booked it, you know, we saw the pilot, we kind of looked at it, and we were like, I know I went home, showed it to my family, it was like, I booked this kid show, it's kind of cheeky. You know, we fight monsters, I'm a superhero, and my family was like, oh, that's nice, that's a good start. and then I came back to LA, and before you know it, I was down at Venice Beach, and people were like, dude, I just bought your toy, and I was like, I have a toy. Really? So, yeah, I had apprehensions in the beginning, but as it blew up and became what it became, I was very happy to be part of it.
Yeah. You know what's funny for me is that I honestly, and I know this is horrible, but I didn't know anything about the show when we auditioned. And I'd heard people talking about it, and I was like, how rich, what is that? And my friend was like, you gotta go to this audition, it's for young kids, and you can, you know, do your thing. And I was like, really? And then I showed up the audition, and there was like a line wrapped around a building, and I was like, I don't know about this. And she was like, no, stay, you gotta do it. And then it wasn't until we actually got on the show that I saw the show, and I was like, wow. And then I started seeing posters, and we were gonna go to Australia, and I was like, oh my God, what is this? And it was just like, I had no clue, and it wasn't really until like now that I come to conventions and I meet all of you, and I'm like, we were talking about it on the plane over here, I was like, I didn't realize how much it touched people. And I've got like a 4-year-old nephew who was like, obsessed with Steve, and I'm like, oh my God, like, he loves Steve, but it's like, I didn't realize until now. Like, I mean, it's been a million years later. Yeah, I mean, it isn't until now that I start meeting everybody that I'm like, whoa.
Yeah.
Like, I guess when you're in it back then and you're young, you just don't really, it doesn't really hit you, so.
And I'd heard about it because I'd auditioned for Dulcia in the first movie, and so when they came back to audition for Kimberly's replacement, I hadn't seen the show, so I walked into it when they were releasing the movie, so it was pretty huge. Yeah.
Well, No, but what we did is we got the history. We knew that there was a long-running show in Japan, and it had already run for like 15 years in Japan before they brought it here. So it was a great concept. And then before the show even aired, all the toys were selling off the shelves. So that was also a good sign. And then once the show aired, then the ratings that we got as far as the Nielsens, they kind of like rate all the shows, let you know what share you got of the market, and we got a huge share. And everybody, all the staff and production people were walking around excited, and like I didn't really know what share meant, but at that time they're walking around going, "We got this kind of share," and they're like, "I'm like, how is that?" They're like, "It's good." So at that point, we knew that we were involved in something that had the potential to be pretty big. And then by the time we went to Universal Studios and we were doing our first big appearance as Power Rangers, we filled up the Universal Amphitheater 6 times in a day, and backed up traffic
freeway,
from
which is
the 101 all the way from Universal past downtown. It was on the news. It was crazy. That's when we really got a sense of how big and how great the show was doing.
But interestingly enough, like just on the side, Haim Saban had the rights and the footage and everything for years and tried to sell the show for what, like 10 years before it finally got aired. He tried to make that show for a very long time, and every network rejected it. And then finally one day Fox picked it up, just to try it out, and then. So all the other networks were probably kicking themselves.
How is your life during the Power Rangers series? Were you like normal people, like, or were people like, "Oh my gosh, you're like from the Power Rangers series," or
do
you see as just
normal people? Well, for us, it was weird because when we got on the show, we started filming episodes, and I mean, we were like working constantly, but they weren't on TV, so of course, we were totally normal people. Then we left, went to Australia for like 6 months, did the movie, and did episodes there as well. And so when we got back to the States, it was like we had been on TV. And it was like crazy. I just remember going at the time, my nephew, he's like probably like 18 years old. I went to his like play or whatever. He was like in third grade or something. And I remember sitting there watching him sing, and he's like singing Christmas carols, and all of a sudden this crowd starts coming, and we were like, "What are they doing?" Like, we didn't know what they were doing. And we were just sitting there, and next thing you know, they were like surrounding me, and my brother-in-law was like, "Get back!" And he was like, "What are you doing?" And it was just like crazy, and I was like, "Oh my gosh." But I didn't know. And I remember being in Vegas one time, and I went to Circus. I don't even know why I was there, but I was walking and we're talking with our friends, and there's like a crowd of people following us, and I'm like, "What are they doing?" Like, I didn't get it, and it was just like the weirdest thing.
Well, how'd you figure out that I was there because of?
Well, then they're like asking me for my autograph. I was like, "Oh, that's me? You're following me?" I was like, "Oh my god!" But I mean, for the most part, we worked all the time. So I mean, you had a pretty normal life because everybody at work, nobody, you know, it was just work. But it wasn't until you like went to places like that people started recognizing you and stuff, and you were like, "Oh my god!" So that was my experience.
Yeah, sometimes people people just. They look at me like a funny look, like, "Did I go to high school with you or something?" that's the way they look at me. They're like, they're not quite sure if they recognize me or where they know me from. So that's kind of how it is. It's still that way.
Yeah. I always make the joke. Some days I have my Aisha face and some days I don't, because I can just do whatever. And then some days I go places and people go, "Archie, oh my God, I know who you are." And I'm like, in a ponytail and it's always those days I get recognition.
Uh-huh. It got pretty crazy for me. Like at a point, because I'm a pretty exuberant person, I got a lot of energy. I'm like, I like to make jokes and whatever. But at a point, it got so crazy that I started hiding a little bit, like wearing the dark glasses and the hat, and not looking people in the face, because really every time for a little while, every time I went somewhere, if one person recognized me, then 8 people recognized me, then 20 people were like, and I would have lines of people signing autographs, and it didn't matter what I was doing. It didn't matter if I was at dinner with my family and about to cut up my steak or something. I had a line of 8 people going, "I want autographs." And then what I noticed is you guys are all like, you were all kids at the time. But what was the kids were cool. Kids were like, oh, hi, and you would say hi, and they were happy. It was like, hey, that made them so happy. It was cool. But adults, parents, they can get a little crazy because they will do whatever they can do for the children, right? So I would have women, like, I'd be standing with my girlfriend at the bar or something, and I had a woman come up and go, come here, you are coming with me. So it's autograph, and then, you know, it'd be like one autograph, and then, and you got to get my niece. I have two nieces and a nephew, and I have a cousin. Oh, call Boo Boo. Who do you need me to get? You know, it's like, and I'm trying to eat dinner. I mean, like, so it got crazy for a while, but it's all been positive. It's all been great. I was happy to be that at the time, and it's better now because I still get recognized almost daily, but it's not, it doesn't take over my life, so that makes me happy.
I want to ask a question for all of you. As far as the show's concerned, is there a villain or a minion that you liked in particular above everybody else, like for each of you, or what your favorite villain or just minion is?
I liked Goldar and Rito.
Goldar!
Yeah,
Rangers!
I thought they were cool. And yeah, the whole Rita and Lord Zedd, I think they were definitely the best villains.
Oh, look at that Iron Man costume. That thing's dope, man. What up? It's cool, man.
I was a big Ivanhoe's fan.
Yeah,
he was definitely a big Ivanhoe's fan. But Rita and Lord Zedd and Goldar, I just don't think there was anything better. No. Like, I've seen, you know, some of the new stuff, and I'm like, you can't beat the old school stuff.
Like, yeah, that's I think Zedd was the coolest one. Like, skinless, you know, he's got his brain hanging out.
He's
got his little
thing
there. Like, he was
but
cool.
But his costume was so, because we used to get the costumes shipped over from Japan. And his, like, nails would be falling off. They were so badly deteriorated by the time they got to us. And so he'd be, like, doing his hand and the finger would be fun. They're like, oh, we've got to tape it. They'd tape it off. Like, what is this? You know? Yeah, it's homemade.
I think it changes for me. I mean, like, I remember different villains at different times, and like some people stick out, like Eye Guy, you know, and Porky Pig. I mean, is it Porky Pig? It was funny just because it was so ridiculous. It was like, okay, the way we won is we gave him radish, and he was like, blah, blah, blah.
I remember that.
Okay, that was pretty funny. So I don't know. I think because Power Rangers had such a variety of villains and just kind of wild.
Anything could become a villain.
Anything could be a villain. Like the telephone would become a villain. The microphone, it's a villain, you know. So, I don't know, it varies. Sometimes I remember different things or I'll see different episodes and I'll go, yeah, that was funny, you know. So,
it was funny how they would come up with a storyline revolving around the footage from the Japanese footage. So sometimes, as you guys know, because you watched it, that just didn't make any sense at all. Like the way that the monster is like, how did he come out of that? You know?
Right.
Yeah, it was funny. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
My question is, what is the weirdest incident you guys ever had with like fans?
That you can talk about.
No. Well, you know what's funny? I will say the parents. Like, it goes back to those parents. I remember we were in. I think it was me and David Yost. We were in. I know. David Yost and I were in Phoenix or somewhere. I forget. We were promoting the movie, and we literally had a table like this. People were coming up, signing autographs, and they didn't schedule enough time. Like, we were there for maybe like 3 hours. And there was a line. I mean, there was a ton of people. So after 3 hours, we had to leave. Like, we had no choice in it. We were like, let us just stay another hour. And so literally, there were little kids there. And we're like, we're so sorry. And we'll, you know, sign more pictures and we'll bring them to the store. You can pick them up or whatever. I mean, I literally saw moms running, jumping off over little kids. Like, they didn't care. Like, they would do anything to get their kid a picture. And we're like, no. And little kids are getting smashed. People are crying. We're like, it was bad. It was bad. And I was like, at that moment, I just realized, I'm like, wow, you probably will do anything for your kid, but look what you're doing. Look what you're doing. Like, this is ridiculous. So that to me was weird. But the kids were always great. They'd either laugh or they'd either be like so happy to see you, or you'd say hi to them and they'd start crying because they just didn't, like, they're like, you're real? Like, like, the reaction from kids was great. Like, it was priceless.
Yeah, like, like how they like hide behind, how you guys would like hide behind your mom.
Like, it was like, I mean, I've seen plenty of kids, like, they go from being happy, and then you walk up to them, and it's like Chuck E. Cheese walks up to a kid, and they're like, ah! Terror. Like, it was like one of two ways it was going to go, but yeah, that was really cool.
I used to get a lot of letters from prisoners.
Yes!
I always got letters
from jail. The jail mail?
Yeah, jail mail. That was interesting.
And yeah, I got a lot of letters from prison too.
I did too. We all did.
Yeah. I liked you on Power Rangers.
Yeah, that was
when the rights shifted back to Saban from Disney, did you guys have any ideas that the series would end with the way Disney was running it as of late, or did you think it would still keep going when the rights shifted back?
We had no clue.
No,
yeah.
That was it.
We're out the loop. They're like, y'all old school, peace. We're out the loop, yeah. But I'm glad for everyone. I mean, like I have, like I said, I have little nephews, so for them, I'm glad it's still on because they're really into it, so. Mm-hmm.
First off, sorry if we went to the wrong room. We live in here. GPS is acting up. But I was going to ask you guys, of all the different, if you remember, all the different Zords you guys have, or like little animals or anything, if you could exchange, like if you didn't like your Zord or anything, which would you exchange, like in any of them, like any of the incarnations?
I think the Master Dan was really cool. I liked my Power Axe, that was all cool, but I wanted to be Tyrannosaurus. It's just a better name to say, Tyrannosaurus!
Hey, actually, you know what? You guys can clear up a question for us, because we were at lunch earlier, and we couldn't remember what the second Zord was in the season two.
Thunder Zords.
Thunder Zords, right. But what was the Mastodon's second?
Lion.
Lion. Mastodon, Lion, Thunder Zord. Okay, couldn't remember.
That's right. I only said that a few times.
Stock footage.
Griffith Thunder Zord, yeah. I liked them all. I wouldn't change. I mean, it was just classic. It was weird how it just made sense for each person. It just ended up being the right thing.
I never understood the whole Zord Megazord.
I didn't really like the ape Zord that much, really, to be honest. I mean, to go from like a T-Rex to a red dragon to an ape.
They dumped it down.
I don't know. It didn't vibe with me, but you know, you got to go with the Japanese show. Whatever the Japanese made is what we had to follow suit with.
Though. Right. Yeah.
I know this is kind of cheating, you guys probably get it all the time. Can you guys say it's Morphin time? On
the count of three.
One, two. Oh, you gotta stand up for that one.
Yeah!
Hey, does anybody have a Morphin?
Well, if you're gonna do it, you might as well do it right. You might as well get up and say your sign and everything. Go
I don't remember the hand movements either. I don't know.
Morphin time, that's all.
Griffin Thunder Zord.
As a Red Ranger would do it.
It's Morphin time! Mastodon!
Woo! You can't follow that.
That's what I heard.
Yeah, you can't follow that. That's what.
Panel's over.
We're done.
I never liked any of these guys.
They're like still best friends. We go to lunch all the time.
Yeah. No, we actually all got along, which is crazy. But we spent so much time together, like 12, 15 hour days. So
yeah.
Thank God we all got along.
Yeah. Yeah, we got along good, but like sometimes, like I was ready to go home. You know.
Yeah.
Like, I'll
see
you guys tomorrow.
Work. It was a lot of work. I mean, there were times where it was just like. I mean, I remember working like an entire year and maybe having a month off in a year. And that's like, you might have had the weekend, and sometimes we didn't have weekends, we'd have one day, Sunday.
Yeah, for a while we were shooting seven days a week.
Yeah, so it was so hard, and like, you know, being young, we just came Steve and I were all, me, Steve and I, and Johnny were all from Texas, and I mean, we literally auditioned for the part, and 4 days later, we were living in Los Angeles. Like, our life changed in 4 days, and you miss your family, and they had to come see you. You couldn't just go. Like, I missed my sister's wedding, you know, because we had to shoot a PSA, and we, I mean, it was like,
yeah, they mailed us our clothes because we couldn't even go back to go get them. We had to start filming right away.
We got the part and they were like, okay, so you're going to start filming on Monday. Call your parents, tell them to FedEx your clothes. And we're like, so yeah.
Yeah, they put your car like on a train. Like, ship it over, right?
And put all my stuff in there.
But was it worth it, you guys?
Absolutely.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay, would anybody else take it too? Of course.
Yeah.
No, I don't think I want to do that.
Yeah, it was absolutely worth it.
Yeah.
At the last Morphicon, Disney to Frank was saying that his character Tommy was written as his own personality. You say that's who's in your character?
They definitely wrote, like, tailored the storylines, like, for Walter, he's dancing, so they kind of tailored it to that. I was a dancer and a singer, so was Karen, so they kind of infiltrated that into the characters, definitely. And I would say my character was similar to me.
Yeah, I think she was really positive, so yeah. I mean, it's. I think we were so young that back then, you're not like this, you know, you're just not like this taught actor, like, we weren't seasoned professionals, mm-hmm. So we just did what we would have done if it were us. Like, that's how I kind of was like, well, what would be, you know, I remember they would always say, do what you feel is true, or what you feel is honest. So you did what you would do, so I think so.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if they meant to, but they made the character sort of like I was, like, my background. Like, I don't know if you know Rocky's character, like, he had, like, six brothers and sisters or whatever. I have six brothers and sisters, you know, a single parent, you know, that whole kind of thing, so... it was very strange in that regard. I don't know how they figured that stuff out. But,
you know. You didn't tell them?
No, huh? No, I don't even think they meant to do that. I think they just, you know. So in that regard, they kind of did match my actual background, which is cool.
Yes.
Just one more question. If they were to make a one more Power Rangers movie where, like, every single season and, like, generation got together, would you guys be a part of it?
The Mega Power Ranger.
Yeah, if everybody came back, I'd do it.
It would have to be union for me to do it, but
absolutely.
Very true. Me too.
I am just—I've been working in the union as a professional actor
for
16 years, so I could not do that. But I would love to be. I know. If they did a union, I'd be like, I'm there. Later. I'm still there.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yes.
Of all the ones that were released, like, let's just say from Mighty Morphin, keep it simple. What's your favorite Power Rangers toy? Like, of all the ones
that
were released, do you guys have?
We didn't have any toys.
We luckily for us, like, we've got to meet all of you, and people have given me toys. We didn't get any back then, you know. And then you had to go buy them, and we're like, we're buying our own toys. What's that about? You know, and they're like, what? So, but luckily for me, I had a Barbie doll. Like a little Barbie doll and dress, and it was cute. And I got all of those for, like, my sisters and my mom. So I guess that's the one, because I was like, it actually, you know, it didn't look like me at all.
The flip top head is very cool. I like that toy.
Yeah.
And the other,
I love that.
And the other toy that's cool was the actual MMPR gun, the one that, like, was also as a knife and you have to flip it over and spin it around. You know, like, that was cool. So I like that.
I like the Megazord. I mean, the whole Megazord, I thought that was really, really cool. I never owned one, but I thought it was a very cool toy. I was like, man, that seems like it would be a lot of fun. But I refused to buy it because I was like, I'm not going to buy this toy.
It reminded me of Voltron, though, too.
Yeah. Yeah. Voltron and Transformers. Yeah.
Any more questions?
Oh, no, this guy had a question.
For all of you.
Walter, what was it like filming the first movie?
I can't recall.
For me, I only shot the first one. It was great. I mean, like I said, our life changed in 4 days. So how long were we? We were on the show maybe like, we worked for about a month and a half, and then we're in Australia. And so that was like a huge dream to go there, you know, and we were supposed to be there 3 months. We were there for 6 months. And we just had a lot of fun. I mean, when you're young, you're exhausted and you're just like, whatever, you just start acting real goofy and start having a lot of fun. And luckily for us, like I said, we all got along, so we just had a really good time out there.
Yeah, the second movie was on a much lower budget than the first movie. So it was a lot of work. We worked really, really long days, and I think we shot the whole movie in 4 weeks or something crazy like that. It was very quick. Might have been a little longer than that, but and it was very low budget. I mean, there was days we didn't have a trailer. Jason and I had to change in a car. It was interesting, but you know what? It was an amazing experience. It was my first feature film, and I had a great time and made the most of it. And didn't really know any better until I did stuff later and was like, oh wow, this is how it's supposed to be.
You
know?
You get fed?
No, you actually get fed. That's amazing. Wow.
They really treat you like a professional,
yeah. Yeah, I remember doing. I was a small part in a movie, and they were so grateful, and they sent me flowers. I'm like, they're sending me flowers. That's so nice. And you know, Saban was like, yeah, move on. We'll get someone else to replace you. So, yeah.
Yeah. I was wondering, since you work with children all the time, with all of you, this is for all of you guys, whenever it came down to Halloween time, have you guys ever thought about
it? I have. I want to do it with my kids next year, actually, because they're just starting to be aware of it. I think that'd be funny.
Hilarious.
I don't know. I can't ever bring myself to do that, you know? I mean, there's like so many other cool costumes out there. I don't know if I want to do that.
Better than the Power Rangers.
How funny would that be, though? Showing up to someone's house and you take your home and go, oh, wow, that's
crazy. It could be funny. I guess I always thought it would scream desperation a little bit.
Please remember me, you know?
What's funny is they used to make us wear that costume to everything. Oh, that's true. And so we were like, anti the costume. Like at one point, we were promoting the movie. They wanted us to do the Today Show with the costume on, and we were like, "We won't do it if we have to." And finally, they let us go on. And I just was like, "I can't imagine sitting with Katie Couric or in the costume."
Oh yeah, that's right. We did the
Today Show. So we got like. So I think. Yeah, I don't know if I could ever do it.
I never had to do that. We always had to wear that color.
Yeah.
It took me years to wear pink again.
I didn't wear yellow for a long time.
Yeah. Yes.
What was your favorite moment from back in the day from My Morphin Power Rangers? Favorite scene?
From before the show or?
Yeah. Back when Walter Jones was Black Ranger.
Yeah.
What was your favorite moment?
You know what, I had a lot of fun doing all the fight scenes. That was so fun to me. I mean, and as the show progressed and as it got, you know, like towards the end, I was really finding my rhythm, and it was like, the stunt coordinator could no longer tell me what to do, because I was like, now choreographing my own fight. So I was like, okay, I want two putties coming here. I'm gonna do a front flip at this guy, I'm gonna kick this guy. This guy can hit me, and then we'll do this. We'll tussle. I'll do this move like this, pow, you know, and I hit somebody. And I just had a lot of fun being really creative with that, like in the vein of Jackie Chan in a kind of way, you know, like fighting on the swings or the picnic tables or jumping across stuff. I did one fight, and you don't see it real well, but I was so proud of it because we were fighting in the park, and I had a putty chasing me, and I run and I do a dive through the chains of a swing, through the chains, a front flip over the putty to stand it over there. He ducks, I dive through the chains, do a flip, land, kick him, he falls into the swing and knocks into the other putty. And it was like, that was a pretty intense stunt, and I was so proud that I'd done it. And when I saw it on TV, I was like, you can't even tell I jumped through the chain. I was like, man, they didn't cover it right. Oh, but it was a lot of fun though.
Yeah, like that was the thing that I liked too. The choreographed fights, because I've been doing martial arts for 25 years, you know, and gymnastics for a long time too. I did so, you know, I loved like putting that together, you know. And they let us choreograph our own scenes, which is really cool. But I just really hated it when they scaled it back.
Yeah,
you know,
did.
Like
I
for
know.
Example, like you guys got ripped off in Power Rangers 1 movie because in the amount of fight scene that we did is like twice as long as what you guys saw in the movie. Like there was so much more cool stuff that we did in it, and they cut it like
we
all out
for weeks
because
doing that fight.
Yeah, because you know they were still thought it was too violent, you know, even for the movie, you know, like the TV's one thing, but for the movie it's like, come on, you know.
Yeah.
And like we were kicking putties in the head and their heads were exploding. Yeah. Not putties, but the ooze guys or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And you know, like there was one scene where like where the two guys like kicked the guy's head together, like, what? You know, like,
oh yeah,
like it was an actual splat.
Yeah.
Like his head like exploded and like goo went all over the guy's legs, you know, when they kicked him. It was really cool. You know? Turned into like this, you know, oh, it was too violent.
Yeah, we always got like, that's the thing, like a lot of stuff you didn't see because they were like, oh, it's too violent, kids are, you know, beating each other up, and you know.
And you were.
And you were.
You guys are watching TV shows.
Like, they totally stopped us from fighting. Like, you notice at one point we didn't do any civilian fights anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, because of that.
They changed, yeah, exactly. And then they changed, like, even back in the movie, they changed, like, before it was Usman, they had, like, these giant, like, sewer rats that were going to be, like, you know, Ivan Ooze's, like, you know, creatures that were going to come after us.
They used those rats in the episode that we shot in Australia when, I think it was the White Ranger against the Green Ranger.
Yeah.
Remember the rats? Yeah, we went back in time. Those were the original ooze monsters.
Those were
going to
be the rats, yeah.
The rats.
Like, they just changed up so much stuff, so.
Yeah.
In the very beginning of the show, we did a lot of head hits, you know, and that made the fight choreography a lot more exciting because you're like ducking and you hit the hit, bye-bye, and you know, see the head snap, you know, like that kind of stuff was really cool. And then, you know, people were complaining about it being too violent, so then we had to cut back and we could only do body. And that was, you know, that was cool. I mean, we worked it out. But then, like, the putty started, they changed. So, like, if you had to kick them in the chest and they would disappear.
Yeah.
So the fights became a little more limited there because it was like, okay, you can only hit one target, you know?
Yeah,
but
as a parent, I think that was a good choice.
You know, I did. Well, I would tell parents, like, when they talked about the violence, I would say, well, what you should do is take your child and put them in a martial arts class, because that's what I did. That's what happened with me, and it gave me a lot of self-restraint, self-control, and self-discipline, because you learn in a martial arts class that you don't want to hurt anybody else. You don't want to hurt them, and you have to have control, and control is a big key. I mean, kids fighting with control wouldn't hurt themselves, but thinking that they're invincible, going, ah, you know, that's not a good thing.
Yeah, you're in the back.
I sprained my ankle, that was about it.
Like bruises and stuff. I mean, you'd accidentally kick somebody, you know, or they'd accidentally hit you. Like I think in my fight scene in the movie, I accidentally kicked someone in the face, and I mean,
hurt one of the stunt guys too.
The stunt guys got hurt. We didn't. They were careful. They were professionals, and we were like,
Jason Frank smashed his whole face into the tree one time.
He hurt himself.
He was trying to. It wasn't even part of the movie. He was just goofing around, running up the tree, doing a flip off of it, and he like did it too close, and his whole face went against the tree.
But like the thing about that, if you notice, like on the I think he did it on purpose because he couldn't rollerblade really well. So in the rollerblade scene, he's in the back, always in the back, because he was like kind of wobbly on the rollerblades. And then he hurt himself.
It would have been funny if they showed that part. Yeah. Make him look bad. Just kidding.
Yes. I know you guys seen a lot of the fight scenes in the civilian, but whenever the Power Rangers were morphed into their costumes, were you guys in the costume doing the fight scenes?
Mm-hmm. Not generally. No. Sometimes, though, they did have us do some stuff when it was the Ninjetti for the movie.
Yeah.
Because you could see our eyes too much, so they didn't have us. Sometimes they didn't have the stunt guys do that. We would do our fight scenes for that. But
yeah.
If it was ever, you know, with the helmets on, they would have the stunt guys do it for a lot of reasons. One, because we just couldn't take a chance on us getting hurt. But also because they could film two things at the same time. We could be working on one scene and they could be working on another scene and get a lot more production done that way.
Yeah,
so
it was all about scheduling and just popping them out.
And you got to commend the stunt guys, because
they did in those
helmets. The helmets are like this. You lose your peripheral vision, so you can't really see what's here or here. It's just
They would just be
this, sweating. And they're doing everything they would do. It's
I couldn't do half the stuff that those guys could do. They're amazing. In that suit, you know? So it would have been really looked weird.
And it was claustrophobic. Like, I've never put on a helmet that was like just, I don't know. It just like freaked me out.
Especially when it's hot outside.
It was hot. It was always like a million degrees.
Yeah, and the helmets fog up, so you're like, you start breathing, and it's just like, there's no windshield wiper.
It's like sweaty and stinky.
What's the guy, the commando in the ghillie suit?
Yeah.
Bloopers?
Oh, we had so many bloopers.
They used to show the bloopers at the end of the show.
Yeah, they did.
For me, I guess... Mine was when we were shooting the jumping out of the plane scene for the movie. They all got to do theirs, and then I'm the one after dinner. And so I had to like flip, and then, you know, and then flip. And so I'm like, how high was I? Like, I was like 50 feet in the air. And I flipped, did it, flip, and then I was like, everything. And they're like, I was up there, so they couldn't take me down. So I'm like going up in a bucket.
Oh, no.
Jason Frank and Dave were taking pictures.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, oh,
it was wrong.
I forgot about that.
Those pictures are somewhere.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. Yep.
Question for Walter. I saw on a panel on YouTube that you did. You were telling the story about how. I guess you were playing around and you had a fake finger.
Oh. A lot of people probably already know I'm missing a finger on my left hand. And one day the costume girl she was like, let's play a joke, because they had a mannequin that was painted black in the dressing room in the costume room. Mannequin. So they broke the finger off and she was like, let's play this joke. So. We were doing, it's morphin' time, right? So I put the finger between my fingers, and I was like, we did it one time, I was like, it's morphin' time. And then we were about to do it again, and she went, cut, and everybody was like, what's wrong? She was like, I gotta go fix something. She walks over, and she grabs the finger, and she goes, okay, we're ready. And everybody's like, oh, it's so ready. It was pretty funny, though, it was pretty funny. I was in on it, so. Yes.
All right, Power Rangers and Ninja Turtles.
Rangers and who's gonna win?
No, how was that episode?
Oh, I wasn't there.
What?
Was it?
No. That was space.
It was space.
That was space.
I don't know.
I think Power Rangers got on.
Yeah,
what?
Nickelodeon is doing an animated version of Ninja Turtles. I think.
Is that right?
Bring it back. Yep.
I often get called a Ninja Turtle. People that don't know Power Rangers are like, yeah, this is a Ninja Turtle. I'm like, I am not a Ninja Turtle. I am a Power Ranger. Exactly. I'm like,
I'll also transfer my money to Bank of America.
I just transfer money.
Why were you cut out for internal wound? Were you just ready to move on? Was this any kind of...
It was my choice. I was ready to move on at that point, and they said, well, how would you feel about like just doing part of the movie so we can introduce a new character? And I was like, yeah, that's fine. So, and at that point, I was like, they replaced me with that kid, but I thought it was fine. I actually thought it was a cool concept, you know, at the time. I mean, you know, it was good. I was fine with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. This one's for Walter.
Yes.
What do you think of the reversioning Disney did of Mighty Morphin Season 1?
You know, I thought it was pretty interesting. the doings and the pow and that stuff reminded me of Batman. I'm like, okay, that's kind of weird. I thought it was colorful, you know, and maybe... I like the old version better.
Yeah.
But I thought it was like a nice revamp to maybe... you know, appeal to the kids
make
nowadays that get to see a lot more stuff. They're a lot more visual, so it was all right.
They had a... with my contract, it was a probationary period. And then once they kind of saw that I was accepted or not accepted, I would have been shipped back. And then they had it set up so they would kind of sign you. Sign you for several years. For several years for, you know, and they would up your pay slightly each year. Yeah.
Real slight. Yeah, it was
very
a year contract.
Very minuscule amount.
You guys probably make more money than we make.
You got a question in the back.
Yeah. While you're running for Power Rangers and all the seasons you've worked on Word Protection, alongside Siobhan, you also work on Sister Show, VR Troopers,
yes.
Writer, and the Big Bad Beetle Wars.
Yep.
Don't forget Sweet Valley High, too, man.
Yeah, Sweet Valley High.
That was my favorite show.
Yeah, we go over there on lunch.
They filmed right next door to us. They were all on the same stages, so we would go over there and hang out with them, and they'd come over and hang out with us.
Yeah. We knew all of them. Yeah.
I never made out with anybody.
He bases everything on how good a kiss is someone.
It's a good thing.
We only have 10 minutes, so any more questions?
Sure.
Yeah.
What was your guys' most memorable moment at Power Morphicon this year?
You.
Yeah. Jeremy comes to everything.
He's come to like all of our shows, like
everything.
He's dedicated.
We see him all the time. It was meeting the fans for me, because I mean, it blows my mind that. I remember Steve calling me saying, hey, I'm going to this convention, you should come with me. And I was like, what? And he was like, yeah. And I go, they probably won't even remember who I am. And he was like, no, come, it's great. I went to one. It was a great experience. You should come. And we went to Chicago. Yeah. And it blew my mind that it was this, you know, for everyone. And it was just, even after Morphicon, I was like, I was just blown away by it. And my boyfriend was like, think about when you were a kid, like whatever it was that excited you when you were a kid, that means the most. And I was like, and I got it, at that moment I got it, and I was like, wow, okay. I didn't realize I was that for a lot of people. So
there was a guy at Morphicon who had a tattoo of the Power Rangers on him, which it was very kind of extreme, but when he came up and talked to us personally, and he was saying how he'd had a really hard childhood, and he was, you know, abused and all kinds of stuff, and the show got him through that difficult time. And when we heard that story over and over and over, people just...
Different versions.
Yeah, and it was just really touching to know that you've affected people like that, and that, you know, it's much bigger than you expect it to be, you know?
Yeah.
And it was also like they had the red Ranger tattooed on his leg. That was cool.
Yeah.
The Red Ranger, I was like, that's what's up.
And he had us all sign his arm so he could get our signatures in tattooed. I mean, I know it sounds. I know it sounds, but it was. He was just.
That's a good idea.
When you heard the backstory,
it was like, whoa.
I mean, I know childhoods are rough, and everybody goes through different things, and you just. We never had a clue that this show meant so much until now. Like, I mean, even when you're back then, you don't get it, you know, until you actually now, 15 years later, you're like, wow. Yeah. Thank you.
I thought the thing about it was the fact that there were so many dedicated fans to just that particular show. It was like, wow, people that are here are really here for us, you know. And as compared, like, this is great. It's an anime convention, and everybody's here, and we are part of the anime convention. You guys didn't come just for us, or some of you did, but a lot of people came for a lot of other things. But to be the focus and That was pretty very. That was a lot of very cool.
Yeah. Scott somewhere around here. He made that all possible. So
absolutely.
Thank you.
We're doing another one in 2 years, I think. So.
Yeah.
You have a question?
Next.
I would just say that Walter, you're always my favorite Power Ranger.
Aww. Mine too, Walter. Mine too. Wait, you make sure you give me a hug before I get out of here. Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, just stupid stuff. You know, like pinching people, knocking people over, running up trying to say their lines, laughing and playing jokes and...
making faces while they're looking on camera.
You know. you know, like, okay, here you go, say your line. Stupid stuff. But we had fun. We had a good time. We were pretty close, close cast. And yeah, it was good days.
Didn't Bulk and Skull take all the furniture out of your out of your dressing room?
I came back from set
and all her whole dressing room was empty.
They hid all my furniture like crazy.
That's funny.
Hey, first off, I want to say with the Power Morph company, you guys were amazing to me. I met all you guys, and you guys were so awesome. And my question asked to deal with what I said to you guys at Power Morph Con. You guys don't look a day older than you were on the show. Do you have any tips on
beauty secrets?
I was doing karate because you guys back in the 90s. And do you think it's too old being in my late
20s
now and stuff like that?
Not at all. Not even close. Yeah.
No way.
Stay physically
fit. You gotta wear spandex. That's what
we can do. I would say one of the keys to looking young or to being young is to always look at life with the cup half full, you know, to count your blessings. Because if you do that and you realize that every day somebody is enduring something that's 8 times worse than what you could ever be enduring at the moment, then you count your blessings and you be happy for what you have at the moment. Live in the now.
Yeah.
That's true. Every time you start thinking about what you don't have, that's just more stress that you add to your life, and then that's what really gets people is stress.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
Yep.
You know, don't add any more stress to your life than already exists, you know, by thinking about all the stuff that you don't have, you know?
Yeah. Staying positive.
This is a quick way to go.
This guy right here having a black jacket, he's been wanting to ask a question and we've been passing.
Well, you guys kind of answered it. I was going to ask, besides yourselves, who's your favorite Power Ranger?
Mm. Ooh.
I love Tweet. I mean, those are huge shoes to fill. Yeah. So. That the Yellow Ranger, she set it off. Like, I mean, it wouldn't have been, you know, I think the Yellow Ranger had, you know, was sassy, she was tough, she had all these things, but she started it off, so.
I would have to say that my favorite Power Ranger was probably Tommy, the Green Ranger. I mean, and not only because he was a good fighter and everything, but his story was awesome.
Yeah, he had the best storyline, you know?
The Green Ranger, he became the White Ranger, he was the Red Ranger. It was come on, man. I'm like, he had the best written story of all the Rangers. And so he was cool.
Yeah, mine was Rocky. That was my favorite character. I liked him the most because Star I felt here, like, you know, he reached out the most. He tried the hardest. He got the most chicks too. He had a blind girlfriend, you know. Respect that, you know.
I liked all of them for different reasons. I mean, I think the originals were special because they were the first, and they had you had very defined characters. I think after that the writing wasn't as good. And
I think after we left, the Saban wanted to make sure that the actors had no power anymore.
Yeah.
So they just concentrated on the costume.
Yeah. So I think the originals are probably, from what I saw, were the best. Yeah.
I came in here extremely late, so I'm sorry if anybody's already had to do this, but for Steve, Karen, and Catherine, can you do the morphing sequence
For what?
For when you morph into the Ninja Rangers.
How do we do?
Bring them up to the panel right here. Yeah. That's
Tank's right.
Woo! Watch that phone right there. Somebody dropped their iPhone right here.
Oh, that's my iPhone.
With me, everybody, all right? Ninja Ranger power now!
Wow. Nice!
Yeah, that works for me!
Seriously, how can we follow that? Look at that. I think
so
that we wouldn't do it justice.
Punch each other.
Yeah. We have 2 minutes. Is there any other
questions?
Yes.
Could I get a picture of you all together?
Yeah. Why don't we wait and see if there's any other questions?
Yeah.
And then we'll take pictures. We'll stand here and take pictures. And you guys can snap away. Yeah.
Where's
The thing about it, when it came on every day, we couldn't keep up. And it got so popular, and it was like, we couldn't keep up, and then the movie really threw a wrench in things. We were only supposed to be there 3 months, and we were there 6 months, so it was like, the show kind of suffered a little bit. Before.
Yep. Yes.
I think this has to be the last question. We're getting signals that we got.
Yeah, we're just going to be the last question.
We got to go sign now. Autographs.
Was having any sort of martial arts background?
Absolutely.
Yeah. For the girls, it wasn't.
Not for the girls. In the original cast, they wanted everybody to have some martial arts. The audition called for everybody to do the acting scene, to do some martial arts, and also do some gymnastics in the original, in my cast.
We do have to do a martial arts. In my audition, I had to do a martial arts scene, but that was kind of a joke. I mean, I had my friend who was a martial artist show me, and I was a dancer, so I could kick high, and then I just fluffed it, but once I got onto the set, that's when we had training and they showed us what to do.
Yeah, our cast, you had to be a dancer, a gymnast, or a martial artist. So yeah, if you're one of the three, you could audition.
If you knew how to do one of those things, they would they would consider you. So.
And we were all smart. I mean, they had amazing martial arts routine. I was actually, we went in by ourselves and then they kind of grouped us and they grouped me, Johnny, and Steve together. So I got to see them do their, you know, whole fight, you know, audition scene. They were amazing. And I was a dancer, and I just threw a couple of kicks in there, and at the end I kind of did like a martial arts dance or something, so it worked.
It was very impressive, actually.
Thank you. Thank you.
I don't know exactly where we're going right now, but we're going to sign autographs, so if you guys want to get pictures and all that stuff there, autographs.
Just across the hall.
Just across the hall. All right.